It's 6 o'clock, hour 18. The curve is rising. These aren't COVID cases, but spending by the state of Illinois. And the woman writing all those checks explains where every dollar is going.
Lines to get computers to enter the virtual classroom. Who's helping out to make sure every student has the chance to learn?
Check out the rock star treatment these nurses in the suburbs got today. The story behind this heartwarming video.
$168.5 million. That's how much taxpayer money has been spent since March 24th battling the coronavirus pandemic in Illinois.
Yeah, let's dig into those numbers. We've been doing just that. How's that money being spent? Here's what we found. According to a new online portal by Illinois' comptroller, at least $44 million spent to purchase more than 41.5 million masks. That since March 24th. $26.8 million went to purchase 1,500 ventilators, and more than $3 million was spent on 15.5 million gloves.
And even $23,000 for 50 cases of postmortem bags. Joining us now is the woman who wrote all those checks, Illinois Comptroller Susana Mendoza. That last item, Susana, body bags, it paints a sobering picture of what we're up against.
100%. You know, that those are those moments where it just really, it hits you so hard to think that we are preparing for the worst, right? That that those body bags carry an absolutely cherished and loved person to someone's family. And, you know, again, it's an opportunity to reflect on this. And also we can never thank enough those first responders who are out there trying to prevent as many casualties as possible.
Ms. Mendoza, we appreciate the transparency with the data portal showing where the money's going. How much of these supplies that have been bought with that money do we know has actually gotten to first responders to point B, to where they're supposed to be?
So the good news is that, as far as I know, most of the supplies that have been ordered have either been received or are on their way. And then once we receive them, we have quickly dispatched them. The governor's office, I should say. We pay for them in the controller's office, but the governor's office has done just an amazing job, Governor Pritzker, of making sure that those products get into the hands of those first responders, whether it's the doctors or the nurses or the other people working in the hospitals, and also making sure that our first responders in terms of police and fire also have the supplies that they need.
The smallest item on this list, just some $16 for plumbing supplies from Menards, but take us through why it's so important to track every penny spent. We're talking about taxpayer dollars, right?
Sure, that's exactly why. I mean, from the very beginning of my tenure, which was back in December of 2016, in the middle of that budget crisis, I have always felt that it's very important to make sure that taxpayers have a sound understanding of how their tax dollars are being spent. We have really championed transparency. It's at the core of what we do in the controller's office, and we are spending a great deal of money, as we should be, making sure that we're getting the equipment that we need to fight this war against coronavirus. But I also believe that at the same time, taxpayers deserve to know how we're spending the money. And I also think there's another story to tell there. That we are spending so much more for so many products that shouldn't be costing what they are. Essentially, the prices have been driven up significantly, and we're competing against other states for the exact products like face masks and ventilators and eye shields, and that shouldn't be happening. Really, I truly believe with every part of my being that President Trump should have invoked early on the Federal Production Act. And had he done that, we'd have American companies producing the face masks, the shields, the ventilators here in the United States of America, and we wouldn't have to be paying black market rates competing against New York or New Jersey or California. Every time we win one of these contracts, it's important to remember that another state in our country loses, and that means people die unnecessarily. It's really a shame.
An interesting point you brought up. Well, I was doing just a quick math earlier, $44 million and 41 million gloves. That's more than a buck a glove when a glove should cost somewhere around 80 cents, so 20%. I mean, that is a hefty toll. We do know this is taxpayer dollars, as Erica asked, but where specifically is the money coming from? Is it a general fund? And is there any anticipation we will get this recouped from some kind of disaster relief, or is this money out the door?
So, you know, as the controller, I have at my disposal the ability to interfund borrow. So, you know, coming up with these amount of dollars when they were not dollars that we budgeted for is always a difficult thing to do. It is my job to prioritize how we spend the limited general revenue fund dollars, as well as how we access other fund dollars and borrow them temporarily so we can make these big purchases in essentially a 24 to 48 hour period at times. So, you know, my job is to make sure that we're getting the funds necessary so that Governor Pritzker can do the best job that he can in fighting this COVID-19 and giving an appropriate response from our state. But, you know, we are going to need additional help from the federal government. And in terms of the federal funds that are going to be coming to Illinois from the CARES Act, we're going to make sure to find every opportunity that we can to spend taxpayer dollars where we're getting federal reimbursements or matches so that we make the best use out of every single Illinois taxpayer dollar. If we can get a match to that, then that means we're essentially, I don't want to call it free money because it's money coming from the federal government, which is also taxpayers, but it's the best use. I'd rather turn $1 into $1.50 or $2 with federal matching dollars. And that's the best way to get the most amount of products for the least amount of Illinois taxpayer cost.
All right. Susana Mendoza, Illinois Controller, thank you for your time here on our Hour 18.
Thank you. Please stay.